but you will know be alright. I'm all by my cracking. I see a rook up by tick tock, pretty baby. You can get it back, don't you waste it. To grow from your past, gotta face it. Oh, yeah.
You're the king of the kingdom.
Scholars, we always talk about how you are our future leaders. You are going to lead us into this kingdom that we keep fighting for. You are the key to the kingdom. I love that song. That is T.Y. Savage. She is a huge superstar artist from Nigeria. And those photos are from 2B, Kush Banks. And you guys are going to see more photos brought to you by Sister Dasha and her great app that she's using with scholars. At this time, family, let's all stand in a strong angalea and get ready for the pouring of libations.
We pour affirmations to the permission given by our head of school and CEO, Dr. Mama Aisha Imani. Ashe, we pour to the gift of life, love, laughter, and learning, Ashe. And we pour to new beginnings, Ashe. We pour libations to the cradle of civilization known as Africa, Ashe. And we pour libations to the kingdoms that we are named after, Ashe. Nations like the Yoruba Nation, the Congo Nation, the Kush Nation, the Songhai Nation, the Zulu Nation, and the Maasai Nation, Ashe. And we want to pour libations to the kings and queens of the African kingdoms, like King Indubis of the Aksum Nation and Queen Moremi of the Yoruba Ila Ife Kingdom, and founder of the Mali Kingdom, King Sundiata Kida of the Gambia. And we want to pour libations to the freedom fighters of the continent of Africa, freedom fighters like Patrice Lumumba, Steve Biko, and Charlotte Max. Ashe. And we want to pour libations to the Maafa, the Middle Passage, the millions of lives that were lost in the transatlantic slave trade. To them we say Ashe. And we pour libations to those who survived, those who made it across the Atlantic. We also pour to the kingdoms of the Americas, North America, Central America, South America, and the Caribbean, like the Mayas, the Aztecs, the Taínos, and the Olmecs. And we pour libations to the freedom fighters of the New World, freedom fighter artists like Marian Anderson and James Baldwin, and freedom fighters like William Still and James Fortin. Ashe. And we pour affirmations to the institutions that teach us about our history and guide us into the future, like the HBCUs, the historically black colleges and universities, HBCUs like the University of Maryland Eastern Shore, Cheney University in Pennsylvania, Florida A&M University, and Spelman College in Georgia. Ashe. And we pour affirmations to the institutions like Imhotep Charter Institute and Sankofa Freedom Academy Charter School and the Freedom Schools Movement. Ashe.
Ashe. And we pour libations to our ancestors, those in our direct bloodline, those who built the foundation for our families and helped mold our families. Ashe. And we pour it to the educators, those who learn about our history in order to teach us about our history, but also to teach us about our greatness, Ashe. And to you, the scholars who are learning today in order to lead us in the future, Ashe. And to the babies and the babies' babies and those yet to come, those who will come and complete our circle, Ashe. And lastly, family, we pour it to the ancestors in hopes that they receive and accept this libation, Ashe. Ashe. Ashe.
The principle of the month is Umoja, and that means unity. The Maotic virtue of the month is harmony. Ashe. I have a recognition. I said I have a recognition. That's right, family. It is now time for recognitions. And we are starting with Yoruba Douglas. Mama Dana would like to shout out our quote of the week from Osei. He said, "A pouch is a fanny pack where kangaroos carry their babies." That's absolutely right. A great analogy, Osei. And shout out to the high frequency word warriors. All of Yoruba Douglas, you did a great job yesterday. And to our parents, thank you so much for all that you do with us each day. And Mama Pat would like to recognize Jewel Wells, Nasai Lipscomb, and Mason Freeman for being more attentive and completing their work. She would also like to recognize the following students for always doing their good, better, best, no matter what is happening around them. And they are Zori Artis Powell, Charlotte Bowens, Chloe Brenham, Aiden Dixon, Milan Hamlin, and Taylor Lomax. And Mama Pat would also like to recognize Bella Smith for persevering through all of her technical issues. For the Kush Nation, Sister Amanda would like to recognize Harley Governor Johnson, Aaron Bell, Alaysia Glover Daughtry, and Jahan Hicks for amazing participation. She would also like to recognize Aria Gordon, Skylar Glover, and Lyric Williams for always being in their Nia. And lastly, she would like to recognize Brother Dre for doing an amazing math lesson yesterday. And for Kush Banks, Brother Dre would like to recognize Izeem, Daylin, and Jade for doing a great job in small group time. And Mama Angie would like to recognize all of Kush Banks for their awesome chat blast work answering questions in literacy and math. For Zulu Fortin, Baba Chris would like to give a special shout out to those scholars who keep showing up and showing out every day. Thank you to those scholars who participate throughout the day and stay on their Nia. We are at 89% with our drills. Let's continue to build Umoja. And Mama Tony wants to give a special humongous shout out to Kasaya Demby. This scholar asked questions and was intentional in grasping the concept of small group. Way to go. And for Zulu still, Mama T would like to recognize Luke, Takai, Samuel, Samantha, and Ronasia. They received a perfect score on their types of sentences test. And Mama T wants to recognize those scholars who never missed a day. And lastly, she wants to recognize their keeper of harmony, and that is Sarani. And Sister Joy would like to recognize Liam Starchia for doing a very good job, for showing off great listening skills and dance moves. You are awesome. And family, we have two birthdays today, Wednesday, October 7th. And those birthday shout outs go out to Sakai Whiten. Happy birthday, brother, to you, and to Rayvon Townsend. Yes, happy birthday, brothers. I hope you guys have a wonderful day.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Ashe, man, congratulations to those scholars who continue to be recognized. You hear a lot, well, adults hear a lot about schools across the country where students are just not getting enough education at this time. They're either not participating or there's just not that resource being provided. But I'm really proud that at Sankofa, we are having perfect attendance in some of our classes. We are wearing uniforms and for the most part, and we're just doing such a great job, and I truly appreciate it, and I am proud of all of you. Be on the lookout for a newsletter that is going out. Your parents should be receiving it soon, and our Scholars of the Month should be in there. You will see some of your faces, and every month we'll be giving out a newsletter updating your parents on what's going on of the school year, and you guys will have an opportunity to have your photos in that as well. At this time, let's all stand in the strong Angalaya once again and get ready for our morning pledge.
We are the scholars of Sankofa Freedom Academy Charter School.
We are the sons and daughters of greatness. We are the descendants of those who love scholarship, justice, the arts, and the earth.
We take pride in our diversity and find joy in our unity.
We respect our ancestors, our elders, ourselves, each other, and our environment.
We honor the principle of Sankofa and reclaim our roots to build a brighter tomorrow.
Every day in every way,
we shall learn so that we can teach.
And we shall teach so that we can change the world.
We are Sankofa Freedom Academy Charter School.
Working to restore excellence in scholarship, culture, and community.
One heart.
One love.
One earth.
One people.
And so that was Marian Anderson, our ancestor of the week. And she said, everyone has a gift for something, even if it is the gift of being a good friend. And that again is another quote that has kind of two parts to it. One, everyone has a gift for something. And then the next part, she talks about being a good friend, because that's a gift as well. Being a good friend requires listening and understanding. And I'll get to that in a moment, but as far as everyone has a gift for something, too many times I hear young people say, well, I don't know what I'm gifted at. And everyone has a gift for something. Whatever it is that you're passionate about, whatever it is that you love, you can make that your gift, and you working towards that can be your gift. But I want us to think about what it is that we are gifted about. And I want us to have a conversation about that. And maybe we can have that conversation with a good friend or with your classmates. And that requires listening and understanding. And that's what I want us to reflect on today. I feel that it is important for us to know our greatness, know what we are good at, but also be understanding and be good friends towards one another. We're all going through this whole cyber experience together. And I'm just looking at the pictures. I see so many of you just being with your families and being with your cousins and everything. And I'm really hoping that you are all taking this time to be good friends, because that is a gift. But what else are you gifted at? Let's think about that during our moment of silence. And once we think about what we are gifted at, let's share it with our classmates, maybe with your facilitator, or share it with your families at home. The moment of silence begins now. Ashe. So family, I hope you all have a wonderful day. I will see you throughout the day. It is Wednesday, and so today is rights, and so I will see you all today, and we're going to be working on Aquasanab this week. So family, make sure that your cameras are on, you are on mute, and that you are showing your heads and your shoulders, and I will see you all later on. Peace. Love you. Bye-bye.